S. Balakrishnan is working as polymer consultant and visiting faculty in the area of polymer science and chemistry. He has completed BSc at Arinjar Anna Government Arts College, MSc at Ramakrishna Mission Vivekananda College in chemistry under the University of Madras, ME in polymer technology at Delhi College of Engineering, University of Delhi, and PhD in polymer engineering at IIT Madras. He has worked for 3 years as postdoctoral scientist at Polymer Division, Howard University, Washington, D.C., USA. He has worked as senior research engineer for 2 years at Institute of Microelectronics, Singapore, and as assistant manager, Polymer Division for 3 years at Precol Limited, Coimbatore. He has also worked as polymer consultant with Skyline Resins and Chemicals and other firms for 4 years. He is having 8 years of teaching experience in polymer science and chemistry in SIPET, Chennai, and Karpaga Vinayaka College of Engineering and Technology. He has published 16 research papers in peer-reviewed journals and presented more than 25 papers in national and international conferences.
Welcome viewers for the UGC program on polymer science. We are seeing polymer blends and composite subject. In this episode, we will be seeing polymer blends compatibilization methods. Contents of my talk: introduction, polymer blends and alloys market, methods, compatibilizer additives, interface structure, twin screw extruder, reactive extrusion, morphology development. So, the importance of plastics, why plastic is being used very widely. So, the reasons, so the oil crisis in 1970s and after the World War II, the Japanese industry's competition, which all made the importance for plastics, wherever applicable, plastics used in place of other traditional materials like metals or ceramics or wood. Compete with other materials based on weight savings, design flexibility, parts consolidation, ease of fabrication. So, in industrial engineering applications, so the weight savings plastic component compared to other components like metal based on metal or ceramics is very well known, and then design flexibility is also well known, but the foremost importance, parts consolidation. Many components can be made as a single molded component, that is a more advantage of the using plastics because of the latest developments in the injection molding technique or other molding techniques. These parts consolidation, many parts in any automobile or any other sector can be consolidated as a single product. So, this is very advantageous for mass production and cost cutting, and then ease of fabrication. So, these are the major reasons how the plastics occupies or replaced many traditional materials. So, and then why use plastics? So, because polymer can be very easily made blend or alloys using by the latest development using compatibilizer technique. So, very easily we can merge the properties of commercially available polymeric materials into blends and alloys. So, this method, so that the any stringent engineering application, the polymer plastics can be used. So, and then plastics advantages over metals, so that factor. So, polymer applications in automobile, so due to these favorable factors, so the one sector we can see the polymer applications in automobiles, instrument panels, engine inside the component, also polymer based engineering plastic can be used, and the windows, tires, body panels. So, this one sector applications, so host of applications in automobile can be used based on the plastics or some special rubber materials. So, you can see in this slide, so the market, so the importance while seeing the polymer blends and alloys, what are the importance major sectors is given in this slide. So, one is the automobile sector and present, and then by 2020, and then electrical electronics, second major sector, industrial sector for the polymer blends and alloys applications, third consumer goods. So, if you see this slide, so the automobile sector comes very important for the polymer blends and alloys is concerned. So, immiscible blends, so we are aware of that mixing the polymer just two components to merge the advantageous properties of constituent polymer is not that easy. So, that leads to the immiscible system. So, that is the things we will be discussing in this episode. So, major component exhibits performance properties. So, if you are mixing the blends two component polymer A and polymer B, anyone may be the major component. So, the minor component is added to give the value addition to the polymer 1 major component. So, in such a system, the major polymer takes the exhibits performance properties, and so because of immiscibility and the microstructure, undesired microstructure, pore impact strength and elongation due to pore stress transfer, this is the case in the case of immiscible system. So, dispersed phase can form sphere, lamellar, ribbon type of morphology if you are using suitable mixing equipment and compatibilizer. So, this is some few facts about the immiscible system. So, here illustration shows, so in this left hand side picture shows that major component takes a matrix phase and the minor component takes as a dispersed phase as micro particles. So, if you increase the proportion, so this second component polymer B in the color blue shade. So, if you increase to around equal proportion, so it takes something like morphology, some sort of co-continuous structure. So, and then further increasing proportion of the polymer B. So, here in this right hand side picture shows the polymer A takes the minor constituent. So, polymer B takes the major constituent. So, this is the thing when you are varying the composition up in the two component system polymer blend. So, the how the phase structure can form depends on the which one will be the major component. So, this is the illustration gives idea about if the one of the major component takes the continuous phase. So, the objective controlling the phase segregation, because all along we are saying immiscible system, immiscible means, so what sort of dispersion. So, the desired dispersion the minor phase should go be in the nanometer or up to 1 or 2 micron size. So, that is a advantageous size of minor phase dispersion in the continuous phase. So, that is the phase segregation controlling. So, the dispersion the minor phase should disperse finely. So, that is a tailoring the process compatibilization called compatibilization process. So, by that route, so this segregation can be controlled. So, desired microstructure can be formed. So, that one how we can achieve compositional quenching and using surfactants and using block copolymers. So, and this type of compatibilizers. So, usually a small amount of block copolymer, small amount means maybe 2 weight percentage to 10 weight percentage up to that. So, even 2 weight percentage is sufficient as a compatibilizer to achieve the desired microstructure, fine microstructure for the useful applications in that immiscible. So, resultant system is called compatible blend. So, the compatibilization methods, the major two methods, so are the immiscible blend system lead to making the compatible blend, so that for the useful applications. Method 1 using external compatibilizer, block or graft copolymer compatibilizers are used to stabilize morphology. So, example ethylene propylene block copolymer in the polyethylene polypropylene blend system. So, this block copolymer, so this block copolymer, so the polymer A polyethylene, polymer B polypropylene in this system. So, the block copolymer of the polymer A constituent and polymer B constituent. So, that is a block copolymer. So, it is an example. So, we can say it is a external compatibilizer added to the blend system as a to give the surfactant effect to make the compatible blend system. Second method, in situ compatibilizer. So, in this method N groups of the any one constituent polymer may contain carboxyl, amine or hydroxyl groups. So, like polyamide, polyester, polycarbonate, this kind of engineering polymers contain this kind of terminal functional groups. So, that is taken as a advantageous point here. So, in the such a polymer components reacts and forms in situ compatibilizer when suitable foreign substance is added. So, in this, so more detail will be seeing in this following slides. So, here example, typical example, polycarbonate and the ABS blend system. So, the ABS blend systems functionalized with maleic anhydride. So, while blending this functionalized ABS constituent with polycarbonate, so during melt blending, this functional group, terminal functional group of polycarbonate, more chance to react with functionalized ABS. So, forming in situ compatibilizer. So, that is called the in situ compatibilizer. So, here compatibilization to the level of even 1% increases the compatibility. So, that resultant useful system generated. So, more points about compatibilization of immiscible blends. So, apart from compatibilizer, shear intensive mixer like twin screw mixer may be required. So, this improves interface diffusion, reduces interfacial tension, results finer dispersion and also good adhesion. So, interfacial tension is reduced due to diffusion of the compatibilizer between the constituent polymers. So, finer dispersion and then leads to the compatible blend system. So, compatibilization yields fine dispersion and prevents agglomeration of dispersed phase. So, here the important point, without compatibilizer either of the method, if it is not used. So, the concept called agglomeration, whatever the minor phase dispersed during mixing in the mixing equipment, as the cooling starts, solidification takes place called agglomeration, the minor phase becomes gross, something bigger. So, that is the undesirable. So, that is the drawback that has to be controlled. So, resultant system, blend system improves toughness and impact strength. So, the compatible blend, most of the objective major case improving the toughness of the engineering polymer blend system. So, co-continuous character or IPN interpenetrating network of bases possible by this compatibilization technique. So, here typical example, the top polymer, so the called polystyrene co para hexafluoro 2 hydroxy isopropyl styrene. So, this copolymer made out of styrene monomer and then para hexafluoro 2 hydroxy isopropyl monomer, this copolymer is compatible with polyvinyl alcohol polymer, polymethyl methacrylate polymer and then polycarbonate polymer, any one of these polymer. So, here the reason is, so this copolymer, so because of this hydroxyl group, so because of this hydroxyl group can has a more tendency to form secondary bond interaction with this kind of polymers, polar polymers. So, that is a reason behind compatibility of this copolymer with these, any one of these three polymers, polyvinyl alcohol, polyvinyl acetate, polymethyl methacrylate, polycarbonate blends. So, the reason in the previous system, so copolymer made from styrene and para hexafluoro to hydroxy isopropyl styrene. So, it forms the very strong hydrogen bonds with any group with a partial negative charge. So, the copolymer, such a copolymer, because of the very tendency to form very strong hydrogen bond with other constituent polymer which is having a partial negative charge. So, that is the reason behind the very improved secondary bond interaction, that is a mechanism behind here compatibility. So, easy to form blends of this copolymer with polycarbonates, polymethyl methacrylate and polyvinyl acetate. So, this is a things it favors compatibility. So, in these blend systems. So, next one example. So, what is the how the secondary bond interaction can be attributed in this styrene acrylonitrile polymethyl methacrylate blend system. So, the styrene acrylonitrile is a random copolymer made out of styrene and acrylonitrile. So, the styrene segments are nonpolar, while the acrylonitrile segment are very polar. So, SAN made up of one non-polar monomer and another polar monomer. So this copolymer is miscible with polymethyl methacrylate. So the styrene segments and the acrylonitrile segments of the random copolymer may not like PMMA individually, but they like each other even less. So the styrene segment and acrylonitrile segment, they like each other even less than how they like the PMMA. So the styrene segment and the acrylonitrile segment blend to the PMMA to avoid coming into contact with each other. So the something undesired interaction within this copolymer, styrene acrylonitrile, so that favors attraction to the other third polymer like PMMA, that is a factor here favors this compatibility in this polymer system. So the compatibilizer can be an additive in a polymer blend system. So additives is a very very common foreign substance added in the polymer component to improve any special properties. So these additives are added even few percentage to improve special properties of polymer system. So here this addition of compatibilizer in the blend system can be said as one type of additive. So additives broken into 5 categories of modifiers in the blend system. So mechanical property modifier, surface property modifier, chemical property modifier, processing modifier, acetic property modifier. So this compatibilizer in the blend system may improve any one of the intended property, depends on the compatibilizer and polymer blend system chosen to tailor these properties. So what happens the mechanism polymer blends with compatibilizers by these two methods. So we can see this illustration what is happening in the interface between the dispersed phase and dispersion phase. So method to compatibilize polymer blends using pre-made block copolymer addition to reactive blending. So here in the left hand side micrograph, if you see the illustration, so the polymer A is the dispersed phase and polymer B is the dispersion phase. So one is a dispersed in the continuous space. So how the interaction during compatibilization, what happens we can see in the case of the lower one, pre-made block copolymer addition. So during melt mixing, what is happening? So the block copolymer, so during melt mixing comes some sort of free, so from the interactions within the molecule. So during melt mixing it comes free, so one part of the block copolymer enters the dispersed phase and another segment of the block copolymer having interaction with the continuous space stays in the continuous space. So this is the way the interfacial interaction is improved between the dispersed phase and continuous phase, or interfacial tension is reduced by this kind of block copolymer surfactant. So this mechanism happens during melt mixing. So the second method technique, you see the reactive blending technique. So the dispersed phase having the A functional groups, red color functional groups, and then continuous phase polymer also having the some functional groups. So this A and B can react during melt mixing. So by this way the in situ called during melt mixing, during mixing this B and A in this reactive blending react and forms a surfactant compatibilizers. This method is called in situ compatibilization technique. So this way also, since the compatibilizer formed between the dispersed phase and dispersion phase, so in this way also interfacial tension is reduced and interface strength is improved. So this is a illustration explains how this compatibilizer increases the interfacial strength in both this method of technique. So the first method using block copolymer, advantages: small amount is required, maybe even 2% may be sufficient. Disadvantages: sometimes measles difficult to separate, and a slow copolymer diffusion rate, depends on the melt viscosity in the interfaces. And then in the case of reactive blending, advantages: copolymer formed at the interface. Disadvantages: functionalizing homopolymers some task. So this is the usual common method practiced in making commercial compatible blends for useful applications. So some more details, how the interface is tailored for the favorable position in this picture, the dispersed phase microstructure, some more compatibilizer enters, stabilizes the interface between dispersed phase and dispersion phase. So, there is a gives a more ingress of the surfactant between the phases. So, block copolymers, so it is depends on the application, the composition is very important. So, something this gives the block copolymers example, ethylene propylene block copolymer, styrene butadiene block copolymer, depends on their ratio volume fraction, it takes the special microstructure in the bulk stage of this block copolymers. So, less than 20 volume fraction among the two monomer constituents. So, this microstructure forms body centered cubic structure kind of microstructures. So, the minor component takes the sphere shape and major 80% fragment block copolymer take the major surrounding structure. So, that is a some sort of body centered cubic structure kind of things if it is less than 20 volume 0.2 volume fraction. And in the second case between the 0.2 and 0.35 volume fraction. So, it takes the hexagonal cylindrical shape in the bulk microstructure. And then if the volume fraction of one constituent monomer in the block copolymers greater than 0.35, it takes lamellae type of morphology. So lamellar morphology. So, in the bulk, the lamellae stacked one upon another kind of microstructure forms. So, you can see this how during melt and then cooling. So, this how fast these kind of interactions. So, in this you can understand polymer microstructure once melting and then solidifying, cooling the temperature of the melt, very fast it takes the structure. So, here it gives an understanding. So, without any compatibilizer, the polymer blend system, that is the things is not favorable to form the microstructure. So, the similar polymer consolidates using this different microstructures. So, we can understand during melt blending, if there is no compatibilizer. So, how the polymer A and polymer B would consolidate and segregate and grow agglomeration lead to undesired properties. So, in this microstructure we can understand. So, what will be happen if there is no compatibilizer in the polymer blend system. So, it is a very fast interaction and is very fast process, within second no time this consolidates like molecules and segregation takes place within no time. So, that is the important things points in this polymer blends. So, here the list of commercial polymer blends starting from polyamide 6 polyethylene system to polycarbonate polybutylene terephthalate blend system. So, in the case of polyamide 6 polyethylene blend system, polyethylene graft melicanated compatibilizer or ethylene methacrylic acid zinc salt based compatibilizer. In the case of polycarbonate PBT blend system, ethylene acrylate kind of compatibilizer is used in this commercial polymer blends system to make the compatible blend for useful applications. So, here reactive blending, how it makes the polymer A functionalized with A and polymer B functionalized with Y, it may be terminal group. In the second polymer A X functionalization and the case of polymer B Y functionalization may be side chain. So, during this melt mixing, in situ compatibilizer graft kind or branch type compatibilizer is formed. So, this is a reactive compatibilization mechanism. So, oxazolin is also bridging chemicals commonly used in the reactive compatibilizer technique. So, this oxazolin ring has a tendency to react wide range of 10 terminal functional group may be present in the polymers kind of carboxylic, carboxyl chloride halogen, substituent, amine, alcohol. So kind of any terminal group, this oxazoline functional group can react. So it has very reactivity, kind of wide range of terminal functional group. So this also is widely used practiced method in the reactive compatibilization technique by functionalizing any one of the polymer constituent with oxazoline functionality. So this is a widely practiced commercial compatibilization technique. So here example how react this oxazoline ring reacts with the carboxyl group forming the ester. Here R dash long chain, R is also long chain. So from the one polymer, R dash from another polymer. So this is a copolymer linkage, how it happens during reactive compatibilization. So modification of styrene acrylonitrile. So styrene acrylonitrile contains CN group, C triple bond N group. Using amine ethanol, so it forms a oxazoline ring. So when polymer having the carboxyl functional group, so this styrene acrylonitrile and polymer having the carboxyl functional group links with the styrene acrylonitrile polymer through the oxazoline ring. So this is how the reactive compatibilizer forms. So this kind of functionalization equivalent to the 1 to 2 weight percentage compatibilizer formation, that much minimum level is sufficient, such level low level functionalization is sufficient for the reactive compatibilization technique. So equipments, what the commonly used equipments for the making the compatibilization? One, internal mixer like Brabander plastic order equipment, twin screw extruder, single screw extruder with mixing head, tabletop mini extruders for R&D research and development purpose is available. These tabletop mini extruders can process mix even few grams, 10 grams, 3 grams kind of level mixing can be, such as miniaturized extruders for the R&D purpose is available now. And then direct molding also sometime practiced with the in situ compatible formation. These are the widely practiced, but industrial purpose twin screw extruder technique is used for the making the polymer alloys. So here the typical picture extruder, how it looks. So the gearbox assembly right hand side, and then the hopper. So you through this make a polymer constituents fed, and then the extruder zones. One is first feed zone, and then compression zone, metering zone. So we having the such a commercial scale extruder, the heat control may be 6-7 level of heat control is available. Here the end the die is connected with the downstream. The strands after melt mixing, strand comes out of the die, is cooled and chopped, the granules collected. So this is the way mixing, polymer mixing done to get the polymer alloy granules. So summary of this episode. So polymer blends and alloys in major applications. So we have seen compatibilization methods using external or in situ compatibilizer techniques discussed. Reactive blending technique with examples explained. So interface stabilization and morphology development mechanisms explained. So here sample questions in this episode. 1. What are the major applications of polymer blends and alloys? 2. Discuss two different methods of polymer blend compatibilization techniques. 3. How interface morphology is stabilized with the compatibilizers. 4. Write on various compatibilizers used in polymer blend systems. Thank you, viewers.